morning students, I am going to talk about the heat transfer tutorial on composite cylinder. Okay, so general thickness is normally called as a composite cylinder. Okay, so in a composite cylinder, normally in the particular sum, which is in a case of submarine type. Okay, so in a submarine type, as a 25 mm thickness of stainless steel, okay, so it's a 25 mm thickness of a stainless steel, it's having a thermal conductivity K, and the submarine is insulated on inside. It is an insulated on an inside. This is called as a insulation layer inside with the material of inside with the 37.5 mm thick with polyurethane foam. NMF polyurethane foam, it's having a thermal conductivity of CK is equal 0.026. The problem that we discussed earlier is the insulations are made up on the outer layer of the material, but in the case the insulation is made on the inside of the material. Okay, so the convection heat transfer coefficient on outside, so listen, which is equal to 20 watt per meter square degree. So inside is 20 watt per meter square, which is called as the inside clearly specified, and having a temperature it is as a 22 degree Celsius, that is inside temperature. Okay, then it's outside. At a full speed, the outside heat transfer coefficient is 750 watt per meter square degree Celsius. So it's flowing along the sea, so the heat transfer coefficient is under the forced convection mode, so the heat transfer coefficient is high, which has a 750 watt per meter square degree Celsius. And the submarine can be approximated as a cylindrical system with a diameter 9 centimeter and length of 72 millimeter. In the problem the length is given, but in the earlier case length was not given, so you can take L as a 1, but in the case length was given. So if a seawater is at a 5 degree Celsius, that is the ambient condition, so seawater is at a 5 degree Celsius, and at what rate should be the heat should be supplied in terms of kilojoule per hour. Normally the output Q is asked in terms of hour, but in the case the Q is asked in terms of kilojoule per hour to the inside air to maintain a temperature of at 22 degree Celsius. You have to maintain the temperature inside as 22 degree Celsius. Okay, in this problem the heat transfer is only asked, so how we can calculate the heat transfer. Normally heat transfer Q is nothing but say it is a delta T divided by R. Okay, delta T divided by R. So here normally delta T divided by summation of, which can be written as a summation of R. In a summation of R, there are four restraints present in the particular problem. Okay, so which is equal to delta T divided by four restraints. What are they? So first one is a convective resistance between inside fluid and first layer of insulation. So this is called as a convective resistance. Okay, now we can take the notation convective resistance, we can take, that is called as a R A, otherwise in terms of RB. Some book it may be noted as RA and some book it may be noted as RB. Then this is called as RA. Then second one is nothing but the, that is called as a conductive resistance between this first layer of insulation, that is called as a conductive resistance. So we can take this as the R1. So plus say R1. Then plus second material, that is a stainless steel material. This resistance is a conductive resistance. The conduction takes place in the stainless steel one. And third one, this is the R2. And then fourth one, this is called as the convection resistance from outer stainless steel wall to atmosphere, that is called as the RB. So that is RB. So delta T divided by RA plus R1 plus R2 plus RB. So clearly the values of R1, R2 and R3, listen, R1, R2, R3 and R4, you can take the particular formula from this value. These four parameters can be calculated from the four given values, R1, R2, R3 and R4. So finally, after substituting the appropriate value, you get the value of R1 is equal to, listen, so 20 value of R1 is equal to 24.907 into 10 to the power of 6 degree Celsius per watt, because the unit of resistance is degree Celsius per watt. Because how we find out the unit of resistance? So normally Q is equal to delta T divided by R. So delta T is nothing but the Kelvin or degree Celsius, whatever you take. Then Q is equal to unit watt, and then R is equal to resistance. So unit of R is taken as degree Celsius divided by watt, otherwise Kelvin divided by watt. This is the unit of resistance. Okay. So R1 is equal to 24.9, then R2 is equal to say 715.45 into 10 to the power of minus 6, same degree Celsius per watt, and R3 is equal to nothing but so 8265 into 10 to the power of minus 6 degree Celsius per watt. R4 is equal to 0.655 into 10 to the power of minus 6, okay, degree Celsius per watt. So it is equal degree Celsius per watt. Here, sorry sir, here that is a 10 to the power of minus 6 in the case of R1. Okay, by summation, summation of all the resistance, finally you got the value of 741 into 10 to the power of minus 6 degree Celsius divided by what? This is the total resistance. So then delta T. So normally you find that is a Q is equal to delta T. Delta T is a, there is a difference in two extreme temperatures. So one is outer side is a 5 degrees Celsius, inner side is 22. So 22 minus 7. This is the delta T here. So this is equal to, from the delta T is equal to 22. So here 22 divided by that is 741 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Finally you got the value Q is equal to, okay, finally got the value Q is equal to 82.5 kilojoule per hour. Normally the unit you obtained is watt. How we converted watt into kilojoule per hour? Listen, so generally watt is nothing but say joule per second. The final unit comes for the heat transfer is watt. How we converted joule in watt into joule per hour? So watt is equal to joule per second, okay. Then we have to convert joule into kilojoule. So normally kilojoule divided by that is equal to 10 power 3 second. Again you convert second into hour. So normally 3600 kilojoule divided by 10 to the power of 3 hour. So finally the value what you get the numerical in terms of 3600 by 10 to the power is multiplied by this term, you finally get the value of 82.5 kilojoule per hour. Okay, thank you.